Hi friends, welcome to Taladaral's Kitchen. You are with Nisha to learn today a crispy, crunchy, munchy recipe of banana pepper wafers. So let me show you the ingredients that you require to make the banana pepper wafers. You need to keep all of this ready before you begin making these wafers. So the first ingredient is bananas. I've taken 4 raw bananas here, 2 teaspoons of salt, 1/2 cup of water, 1 teaspoon of pepper powder, a slicer to slice the bananas, a knife for peeling the bananas, and some oil for heating. Usually we do not measure the salt and the pepper when we are adding it to recipes, but here I've stressed on the measures because it's very important to get that perfect taste of the wafers. So let's begin making the wafers now. The first step is to combine the salt and water and make a salt water solution. For that, here's that 1/2 cup of water and 2 teaspoons of salt, as I had mentioned. Mix it very well. The salt has to dissolve completely in the water. This salt solution needs to be made before you peel the bananas, because once you peel the bananas, they will start turning black. So the salt water solution is ready. The next step what I'm going to show you is how to peel the bananas perfectly. So I've taken around 4 bananas. Well, the best would be to take medium sized bananas, but today I've got only the smaller ones. The first step in peeling the bananas is to make incision at regular intervals. So just take a knife, make light incisions all over. But remember, when you are making the incision, the knife should not actually be touching the banana inside. Lift it up very lightly so that the skin can be easily peeled. This is how it will peel if you have given the proper incision, and now you can peel it with your hands also. Well, in making these banana wafers, the major task is peeling the bananas only. The rest is just the deep frying, which does not take much time and neither it takes too much effort. Well, some people also use a peeler, but I would say that this incision method is the best so that you get the perfect peeled bananas for the wafers. Here, the banana has been peeled completely. You will see that the banana has turned a little black, but this is because of the oxidation. Do not worry. This banana is now ready for deep frying. Before I started peeling the banana, I had already put my oil to heat. The oil can be heated on a high flame, but once it's perfectly hot enough, lower the flame to medium, pick up the slicer and slice the bananas directly into the oil. Now when you are slicing, again remember to just go one way, from this side to this side. Do not come back. This will ensure that you get the perfect slices. Another thing, remember that the slicer should not be at a great height from the oil. Otherwise, there are chances that the oil might splutter on you. Add around 1.5 to 2 tablespoons of the salt water solution to this. Well, you've added water to oil, so it's bound to splutter a bit. At this stage, do not touch the wafers. Let them fry for about a minute. After about a minute, just toss them once in oil and then allow them to deep fry. And now if you toss at this stage, you will realize that the wafers are turning slightly crisp. The bubbling has also stopped. So this is the perfect indication that the wafers have been fried well. Drain them on an absorbent paper. Sprinkle a little pepper powder over it and toss it right now till they are little hot, so that the pepper powder sticks to the wafer very well. However, be careful, the wafers are a little hot. Well, there's a little more while to go to taste these wafers. So let this batch of wafers cool completely. Until then, let's begin with the remaining bananas. Start peeling them and slicing and deep frying them. So I've finished frying all the banana wafers. You'll need some patience to make these wafers, because peeling itself takes time, as I said. And then deep frying also takes a little while. because you have to deep fry them in batches. Do not peel all the bananas and keep them and then deep fry. Sprinkle the last part of the pepper powder. So the wafers are ready. Once cool, you can sit and enjoy their flavors. But as you can see, my hands have turned black because of the oxidation of bananas. So a way to remove this blackening is take a lemon, cut it into half and just scrub it on your hands and fingers. You will notice that within half a minute, all the blackening is gone. Just take a tissue now and rub it. And that's my hand, perfectly clean, no blackening at all. So just go ahead, try this recipe in your kitchen and share your feedback with us. Goodbye.
Download the Tarla Dalal app on your Apple and Android devices. Follow us on the Facebook and tarladalal.com.